Welcome back to the channel. In this today's video, we will talk about autopsy. So let's begin. So, about autopsy. So, autopsy is derived from a Greek word, autopsia, which means to see for oneself. This is a surgical procedure that consists of a thorough examination of dead body by dissection. By this process, we can determine the time since death, manner of death, and the cause of death. Then, the purpose of autopsy. So, what is the purpose of autopsy? First of all, it is to identify the diseased, or we can say to identify the person in case of decomposed, burned, or mutilated or an unidentified body. So, this is the main purpose of autopsy. Then to know about the cause of death, whether it is natural or unnatural. Then we can approximate the time of death, mode of death, then the age of injuries and the place of the death, where it took place, like. Then the manner of death, whether accidental, suicidal or homicidal. Then we can see the extent of external and internal injuries present. We check about the external and internal injuries present over here on the body. Let's talk about the history of autopsy. In 300 BC, Greek doctors cut into human bodies to study the diseases. In 1231, in Rome, Emperor Frederick II passes a law that says human dissection is legal. In 1247, in China, Sun Tzu handbook Si Yuan Qi Lu tells how to spot poisonings and strangulations by inspecting the body. Then in 1302, an official in Bologna, Italy asks an autopsy in a case of suspected poisoning. Then let's talk about types of autopsies. First of all, we will look forward to medico-legal autopsy. This is the autopsy which is performed to identify the cause and manner of death and to identify the diseased. They are generally executed as dictated by applicable law in case of violent, suspicious or sudden deaths. This medico-legal autopsy is also known as forensic autopsy. Then the pathological autopsy. These autopsies are executed to diagnose a particular disease. It aims to determine, clarify or confirm medical diagnosis that remained unknown or unclear prior to the patient's death. This pathological autopsy is also known as clinical autopsy. Then academic autopsy. This is the basic autopsy which is performed by medical students for the study purpose only. Then the procedure of autopsy. Here the procedure of autopsy is in two parts, that is external examination and internal examination. First of all, in external examination, we will see about clothing. Here details like design, stains, tears, loss of buttons, cuts, holes, blackening from the firearm discharge with the dimensions, all these things should be noted. Then collection of trace evidences, jewelry, anything from the pockets should be sealed in a bag and handed over to the police. Then the condition of skin is also noted, where rashes, color and looseness of the skin is also noted. Then the general description of the body is done, like scalp hair, beards, scars, tattoo marks, moles, etc. If anything is present, then it is noted. Then time since death is also major thing here, by checking the rectal temperature, rigor mortis, putrefaction and maggots. Then the condition of the eyes is also noted, whether any color changes are there or not, and many other perspectives are seen. Then the condition of natural orifices, like any discharges are there, any injuries or any foreign bodies present. Then internal examination. First of all, in suspected head injury, the skull is open first and then the thorax and the abdomen at last. In suspected asphyxial deaths, the skull and abdomen is open first, followed by the dissection of the neck. And in other cases, the thorax and abdomen are open first and then the skull. Now, the tools used for the autopsy. The tools used for autopsy are like scissors, skull chisel, long handheld scalpel, H-Don needle, entered tomb, bone saw, rib cutters, bone cutters, hammer, brain knife, and toothed forceps. Now, here we will see some of the protocol of the autopsy. First of all, the skin incisions. Here, the first which one is eye-shaped incision. It is extending from the chin straight down to the symphysis pubis and avoiding the umbilicus. Here you can see in the image. Y-shaped incision. Here the straight line of Y corresponding to the symphysis sternum, two pubis incision and forks of Y runs down medially to the chest and extending towards the acromion process. Then modified Y-shaped incision. Here the incision extends from supra-sternal notch over the clavicle to its center on both the sides and then passes upwards over the neck behind the ears. Here you can see in the image behind the passes upwards over the neck and behind the ears. Now we will discuss about the autopsy techniques. An autopsy at its base is a surgical dissection, as you know. There are different correct ways to perform it, but the Lettyul method has become the principal protocol for training pathologists. The particular method finds the pathologist or medical student commencing the dissection at the abdomen. After piercing the abdominal area, the abdominal organs will be removed in one block per this method, which is understandably called the N-block method. The direction the Lettyul method will take is called a retroperitoneal approach. This essentially means that organs will be removed starting with the organ situated directly behind the peritoneum and moving backwards. The peritoneum, in turn, is a serous lining located in the abdominal cavity. It appears like a light colored sheet that will cover and thus protect our abdominal organs. Next, the Virchow method. The Virchow technique will see that the organs are removed one by one, starting at the cranium and moving down to the thoracic, then abdominal and cervical organs. In other words, it may follow a top-down approach if you will. Then the Ghon technique. It is similar to the Rokitansky in that thoracic, cervical and abdominal organs are removed using the block method, but the Ghon will not employ an in situ dissection, instead opting for in block removal. And the last one, Rokitansky technique. It is an in situ, or we can say or local dissection, that starts at the neck and trails down, and the organ is removed as a block as well. The first cut pierces the larynx to separate the esophagus and pharynx, and then the larynx and trachea, followed by the chest organs that are cut to expose those in abdomen. Then the scalp incision. The typical scalp incision involves a cut that is made from mastoid process just behind one ear and over the vertex, means the top of the head behind the another ear. Now, the preservation of samples. Viscera is preserved in saturated solution of common salt. Then the blood is preserved in sodium or potassium fluoride and anticoagulant potassium oxalate. Urine is preserved by thymol or phenylmercuric nitrate. Then vitreous humor is preserved with the help of sodium fluoride. And then the bones, hairs and nails. Here the no preservatives are required for preservation. Let's talk about some of the famous cases. First of all, John F. Kennedy. Here, during the autopsy, we came to know about the cause of death, which was bullet injury on the skull. Here, the manner of death is the bullet entered the right superior posterior thorax just above the scapula and transversed the soft tissues of the suprascapular and supraclavicular portions of the base of the right side of the neck. Here the evidence which was found was a fired bullet. Then the case of Marilyn Monroe. Here the cause of death was acute barbiturate poisoning. Here the manner of death was suicide. She had poisons to kill herself. Here in the evidence, we found 8 mg of chloral hydrate and 4.5 mg of pentobarbital from her blood and even 13 mg of pentobarbital from her liver. Thank you so much for watching our video. I hope you liked it. Make sure to drop a like and subscribe to our channel for more amazing videos. And you can also visit our website, that is www.thesciHub.in. Make sure to follow us on Instagram also. And all the links of our social media are given in the description box below. Thank you so much.